For millions of years, humanity on this planet has lacked knowledge about how brains work in computational terms. And now we face two major challenges. On one hand, humans fight wars and oppress one another. On the other hand, modern-day, general-purpose computers still lack human-like intelligence. After years of cross-disciplinary study and research, we have begun to understand how the brain works in computational terms. Knowledge like this can help resolve human conflicts and enable us to create smarter machines. This series is about brain mind and is here to entertain and inspire you.
So last time we were talking about the trade-off between match. Still remember what that is?
Yeah. Yeah.
Match and OR. This is OR. So basically that, so suppose this happened together once, then this happened next, and this become match. Happen together means match. And happen at different times means OR.
Yeah.
So we have, for example, if this is a vector, they happen different times, then they have a chance of 10% for this particular neuron when they're fired, means the condition aren't firing. And another weight, weight 5, has a vector 2, and has 60%. Then it's like entire energy of match, right? Because this is at different times, then it will not be able to match completely with this entire W. Never happen. Only match factor this one. So then when this one perfect, you only get about 60% of energy matched. It's not perfect match. But if this happened, we get only 10% of energy. This means what? This means that this is like logic. I don't care about this anymore. Before I have these four positions, because the energy is so low, if energy is so low that basically that all those positions, even I put this one, if I this is the position, right, I only get zero error or zero energy for this case. Then this is not there, right? It's so low, right? We're not win it. Because if you don't win in the competition, then it's like originally I have only tried four positions, W1, W2, and this is four location weights, but after this learning, and if even I did not have position matching, all right, position matching, I will not lose much, all right, because the original is a perfect match, only 10% anyway, so it's all situation, and then how do we deal with this W5? W5 is, now this is very interesting, right? Because W5 getting 60% error, that's considerable. So if W5 happened, suppose this has another W5, or right? This is a W5. This is W5 coming out, right? This is W5, correspond consist situation. If that happened, it will get 60% of energy. And I think this neuron is more or less really detected really W5, all right? If W5 happened, other neurons did not fire a weak energy, and then this is not perfect, all right? We call it perfect matching, is the tolerance, basically. If not perfect match, then this will fire. So in this case, it will detect W5 match that invariant to other positions, all right? That's the idea we had before. But today I will talk about something that has been a central piece of our concern in the recent month, which is the different types right? Basically, when the through ages, when age goes on, then what happens? So, what we had before is we have Z area, X area, then you generate Y. This a neuron, all right? And I draw in a different area of Y now, all right? I can have a little bit more. So this is the Y. And originally we have this type. This type is 101 because it did not have a connection to the Y. Maybe this Y has a, this type is 011. Why? Because this is the Y connection. This is have Y connection, but does not have X connection. So this one has, give me an example, that 110. So it has a connection like that. I did not draw other types. More other type is like, I put it here, all right? Put it here. This type has only X. This has only Y. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There's another type. 111. All right. 111. 111 is from here, here, here. There is a 101. 101.
You have 010.
What I miss?
010.
010. 010. Yeah. Put it here. Alright. 010. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Got it. We are complete. Alright. This is 100. This is 001. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the issue is that how do you control these seven types? The option one, a single growth rate based on a single perfect match value. So we make it perfect match like 0.3, gradually 0.4, 0.5, like that. 0.4 is really, really not perfect, but that's what I would call it, perfect match. I mean, perfect match means I do not care. So if reaction is 30%, and we just let it fire, we do not really have to really grow a new neuron, all right? And we can have that. This is called a single growth rate based on a single perfect value. Option two is more or less we have been doing. Sean has been doing that way. Basically that each type, Y type, has its own growth rate. Growth rate actually also has with its individual, every individual perfect match. So that we end up with a table. Give example that what we discussed it, you have a table like that. This is virtual time. Virtual time is like 5%, 10% of the total, 15% of the total. Then you have a type. That type, I have this type, like 100, 110, all right? That has 101, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1. All right, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You have 7 types, then each type will have its own growth rate, all right? And it's not a really growth rate, it's the criteria of perfect match, all right? For example, that is called 0.3, but this is called 0.04, different values. And that, hopefully this is in the evolution, evolution that we may have a different neuromodulator, this is called growth rate, maybe, growth hormone, for example, or the novelty, NE, all right, SH and NE that tune the how much novelty you came up, and then novelty will end up with the spawning of neurons, all right? So basically, our spawning is that the value changes and we have different spawning rate. Of course, option one is simpler. Option one is simpler than option two. I think this is probably more true than this one. This is simplified, easier to program. And this is just special case where you have every row have the same value, you end up with option one, all right? But this is probably more flexible. Now, the issue I'd like to discuss today is that how you can decide those values, all right? So let's still do this. We did not talk about much, actually, before about the... Suppose you have different Y neurons. We have 7 types. Now I put this one in there, and I probably use 001, 011. I'm not sure I do it perfectly, but you know what I mean, right? I want to put those in terms of the this is more X, this is more Z. Z is on the right side, X on the left side. Then the 111 is like middle. 111 is like I want everything, and I have a 101 is also somehow middle, because this is one Y, this is not one Y. Then you have a 010. I'm not sure I did a good job. So this is clearly tuned for Z. This is clearly tuned X. Do you see that? And these three types is that this is Y only. This is everything, and this is no Y. These three should be considered three group. You need to put this group think when thinking that. I repeat again. This is tuned for X, this is tuned for Z, and these three is without Y, Y only, or. Makes sense? Very intuitive. Alright. When we decide those growth rate, we need to consider first of all, task specific, all right? Task non-specific. If we do task specific, you have a problem, all right? So non-specific. All right. Non-specific, I cannot say, oh, I have a toy problem. So I start to use this one for the toy problem, all right? But you don't know what's going on. But you can have some idea that what happens if we want to really the natural setting or what could be typical situation, right? Typical situation gonna happen is what that I think that this needs to be grown because this is the X windows features, S features. But I remember that if we do S features, somehow that if you have Z connection, I mean this one there turned out to be useful. So what I really want emphasize is this one. What is this? This is what we get before. This is DN1. DN1, so I put it here, all right? DN1 says that you have connection from Z and X, but you do not have connection with Y. I think that's really, really useful. I guess it's a spinal cord. I don't know. All right. Spinal cord means that grow very early. If you look at the biology, all right, spinal cord grow very fast, very early, and that does not really have a direct link from the I call forebrain. Why? Suppose why the forebrain? Suppose this is the spinal cord. Why certain part is forebrain and forebrain maybe like this? So this could be no. So I just something that intuitive. All right, this is a spinal cord, and this is forebrain. Forebrain means that I put a question mark because it's only modeling. All right, modeling does not have to be perfect. So this is the spinal cord, and that's like in between. This is in between. I speculate. I'm not saying I'm correct. All right, brainstem. Brainstem. It has connection with the forebrain. I think forebrain is a single word. Brain, forebrain, and together. All right. So if that's the case, it's very rough right now. All right, very rough. If that's the case, then we need to think about what should be grown first. I think that this type should grow first. Then we have brainstem later. Then forebrain even later. All right. So I put the time of maturity, or roughly, right, maturity is for the why I say the spinal cord first, right? Because it grows even in the womb before birth. Then you have a brainstem, right? Brainstem. Then you have a forebrain, right? That will give you a little bit of order of this one, right? Little order of what could be tuned for the growth rate. This means that you do not want this one grow too fast. Mm-hmm. You want this one grow a little bit faster.
Yeah.
Allowed it. Then this one XX. I do speculation. I still doing speculation. So this is I. I is only have connection with the X receptor. All right.
Yeah.
And then you have a. This means Y and X. Y X. This is probably like early Y area called lateral geniculate nucleus. That linked with I, all right, linked with I, then they, with a little bit of Y. Actually, this Y could be itself, itself, or a little bit from V1, you know. Then what happened here, right? So this one is more like, this is a connection to Z earlier. This is called motor cortex, right? Motor area. Motor area that drive muscle directly. So this is drive muscle directly. And this is Y, connect with Y, but still mainly very motor, but still connected to Z. So this is something that premotor area. Right. So this gives you a rough idea of classification with what's going on. Then you need to decide how you do it when at different times. I still have seven types. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. 7, 6. There's seven types, how you can do a connection. you probably think about how come forebrain is hit only one time. The forebrain is probably is connected from Y to Y. All right, this is still very rough in the sense that currently it's only modeling. All right, but forebrain turns out to mature very late. Very late in maturing. Maybe language, maybe high level behaviors, very late. So we like to have I mature earlier, all right, this is earlier, you want to mature early, and for mode, I want to mature early. So that's the rough idea. Now, for if we have toy problem, right? Mm-hmm. When we design toy problem, because toy problem, maybe does not really need much forebrain. Because forebrain is not a toy problem. Forebrain is more individual. Mm-hmm. So in that regard, I would think that we should start with something earlier first. Start with the this earlier one, spinal cord, and the motor, with eye. Then after that, you have this one, all right? Mm-hmm. If I put the time order, probably here, like, this is the first batch you want to go, then the second batch.
This one is the first.
This is my record. Yeah, first batch, all right? So this is the first batch you want to grow. And because spinal cord even did not connect with toy. You grow fine, right? Do you understand? Then you have premotor, this is like second batch. Do you understand? Alright? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Premotor. Brainstem. And forebrain really late. It's kind of symmetric, but maybe simplified. It don't really have to be symmetric. This value does not have to be the same as this value. This does not have this value. Because X has a lot of input. And for toy problem, if you have toy problem, the motor is not very complex. Right? So you don't have to use the same value. And a spinal cord start to lose context. Because without spinal cord, you do not have the context. Then you can only have a very simple behavior that cannot even do a toy machine. So now the conclusion is that in stage one we still have toy machine perfectly can be matched, because this one did not really do Y. And this one did not do Y. This one did not do Y.
Yeah.
So Y growing, but Y is not unfolding on itself, right? Mm-hmm. So we still have a perfect. We still have perfect Turing machine.
Yeah.
Stage one. Stage one. Then if you have a toy problem, then we can work on this one first, for stage one first. Then we still let, after certain growth, whatever, and we start to do stage two, stage two, that. And then we do stage later, stage three later. Right.
Time is
that?
Yeah.
All right. So hopefully that helps, all right?
Okay.